pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Come School. Today is Friday, January 8th, 2016. I'm Jake Bothy.
And I'm Jen Gannon, and it's time for KTV Live Tranquility. So, I don't know about you, but I'm really excited because we made it through the first full week of school since we've been back.
And we did. So, let's just hop into it. So, today's KTV birthday is Elvis Presley. According to FamousBirthdays.com, Elvis Presley was known as the King of Rock and Roll. Elvis was also in over 30 movies. He would have turned 81 years old today. Did you know Elvis had a twin brother?
Today's KTV holiday is Typing Day. According to CheckItDay.com, Typing Day is an annual event that started in 2011. It aims to encourage people to express themselves via written communication. Typing Day will be held on this day because the 8th of January is 1 week after the New Year's, where everyone will have the time to think through and plan what they want to do for the following days. Typing Day was founded in Malaysia.
Seventh graders, if you had Mr. Surwe during marking periods 1 or 2 and are applying for KTV, please visit the Google Classroom app and join the KTV page for KTV applications. All announcements and assignments will be posted there to complete throughout the week.
The seventh graders are learning about American history right now. Mrs. Corby stated that the seventh graders are currently finishing the 13 Colonies unit. During this unit, the students began to learn about the New England colonies, the Middle Colonies, the Southern Colonies, and the Southern Colonies. In New England, these colonies, the religion was number one priority on Sundays. The families would go to church and read the Bible the whole day. As you went south, the importance of religion sort of drifted away. The seventh grade history teachers are Miss Corby and Miss Falzone.
So I didn't get to catch any sports last night. You want to fill me in?
Yeah, I'll fill you in. So there was a lot of hockey last night.
That's
so
good.
Yesterday, in hockey, the NHL, in fact, the Capitals beat the Islanders 4-1.
That's good for the Capitals.
Yeah, it is good for the Capitals. And Detroit beat San Jose 2-1.
I like Detroit.
Yeah, I like Detroit too. And the Flyers beat Minnesota 4-3 in overtime.
That was a close game.
Yeah, it was a very close game. See ya.
All right.
Recently, Alyssa got the chance to ask people about their favorite culture. Let's pass it to her with more on that.
What their favorite culture to learn about is, and a lot of them had different answers, so let's get into the video.
My favorite culture to learn about is the Greeks and Romans in sixth grade, because learning about all the different gods they had was really cool.
I like learning about the Italian culture because the language is interesting.
I like learning about the Spanish culture because it has really great food, like paella or empanadas.
I like learning about the French culture, specifically the language and the food, because one day I want to go to France and I want to go to Paris.
Most people enjoy learning about a culture because of the language or the food.
A toy-like cardboard machine that sells for less than $20 online has helped save the life of a baby who was very sick. Doctors at the Nicklaus Children's Hospital in Miami used the device to map out an operation they say they couldn't have envisioned otherwise.
All right, so
we are halfway through the show.
Yeah, we're almost done with this Friday, so let's go.
Pass it over there.
Thanks, guys. So I'm here with the William B. Harrison Teen Center flyer, and you could go there on Wednesday nights from 6 to 7:30, from 5th grade to 8th grade, and 7:30 to 9 p.m. for grades 9 to 12, Fridays from 6 to 8:30 for grades 5 to 8, and 8:30 to 10 for grades 9 through 12. So they have a lot of video games and stuff that you could do for fun with your classmates. So I know I'm going to join. Hope they do too.
Well, that sounds interesting.
Yeah, it really does sound fun.
So I know I'm going to be there. So
I think I will try to.
Let's just get back into it. Now, Steph got a chance to challenge an eighth grader on how well she knows her teachers.
I
Anna confused Mr. Surweed's culture, which is Norwegian, with Miss Malloy, whose culture is Polish.
The next Drama Club meeting will be on Thursday, January 14th, from 3 o'clock to 3:45 in the Art Room. New members are always welcomed. If you have any questions, please see Miss Greenspan or Mr. Peets.
So you're here with the weather.
I'm here with the weather today.
You are.
It is crazy this week. I mean, today it's cloudy with a high of 45.
Wow.
So, I mean, for winter, 45 is a little high. I like the heat. So, yeah. So, tomorrow it will be cloudy yet again with a high of 48.
Where's that sun?
I know, right? It's just hiding. But I think it comes out at the end of the week. So, let's see. So, on Sunday it will be rainy with a high of 61. Still no sun, but
wow.
it's a little warmer.
61.
I know, right? It's winter, right? On Monday, it will be sunny with a high of 36.
Oh,
so there's the sun.
There's the winter, too.
Oh, yeah, too. All right, see ya.
Around the world, there are many different cultures and beliefs. So I am actually Polish. That's my culture. And I'm Irish. So let's get into that.
According to Buzz.com, there are two different religions within Africa, which include Christianity or Islam. In America, our religions include Protestant, Christians, Catholic, Judaism, Hinduism, Islam, and Buddhism. India has many various religions that may be Hinduism, Buddhism, Sikhism, Jainism, Islam, and Christianity. There are also places like China that has a diverse population of religion. Japan has religions such as Jisha, Samurai, and Kamaru. The Jamaican religion is Rastafarism.
According to religiousstudies.edu, it is important to know about these religions for human understanding, cultural influences, global insights, interdisciplinary learning, and broad opportunities.
Different cultures, religions, and beliefs do not follow and believe the same things as each other. Put on your thinking caps and start thinking. Christianity, Islam, and Judaism all fall under what column? Is it A, culture? Maybe B, ethnicity? Or is it lastly C, religion? The three popular symbols for Christianity, Islam, and Judaism are the cross for Christianity, the hasmonah for Islam, and the Star of David for Judaism. And the answer is C, religion. According to religionfact.com, it states that religion is something that everyone virtually has in common. According to presearch.org, religious switching is a common occurrence in the U.S.
All right, so
we're ending the show here, but I don't think we have a preview today, so let's just end it here. So for even more KTV news, subscribe to us on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook. For Jen Gannon and the rest of the KTV News team, I'm Jake Bothy. Have a splendid day.